Hello everyone, my name is Nathan, and today it's time for another episode of Oxygen Not Included. In the previous episode, I asked you to vote on if we want to ranch Drekkos for our initial plastics or not. Some of you were concerned that we are not going to use the rocketry program, or it would be more interesting to use the rocketry program to get the plastic, and others were really interested in how to actually ranch the Drekkos. I figured we might be able to make a compromise. We will set up a glossy Drekko ranch in order to get some plastic for tiny contraptions, but I will not allow myself to build transit tubes with this plastic. That still means if we want a transit tube system, sooner than later we need to launch the rocketry program. I hope with that everyone is gonna be happy more or less, and it's a good compromise. My Drekkolet egg is right here, and it is actually at 99%. That means it is going to hatch any moment. Let's see this happen. Grub grub, get out of the way. Jeez, stealing the show. Come on, Boots, Boots, I just want to see you hatch. How is this at 99%? Ah, there we go, 100%. Come on. Ah, finally, that took like forever. I just love the Drekkolet babies, they're kind of cute. If we check the room overlay, we want to create a stable for them, maximum size of 96 tiles. We might want to start the farm somewhere it's not too cold. Yeah, I think around 30 degrees is actually better. We need to check the balm lily plants, 35 to 85 degrees even. Okay, we want it pretty hot in there. I think together with the power transformers nearby and potentially a couple of lights, we should be able to raise this to 35 degrees. So I'm gonna make my farm here. We're gonna make sure we insulate this too. Now you can either go for the standard farm, something like this, very elongated. The problem about this, it takes a long time for the Drekkos to actually get to the grooming station. So maybe we're gonna find a design like this, also 96 tiles, but generally the way to the grooming station might be shorter. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. We're gonna set up this room here. I'm also gonna implement another door. Actually, that doesn't make sense. I still need a way to get in there without losing the gases, and even better, it should be with an exosuit. So I think instead of doing that, we're gonna raise it one floor. Theoretically, this would allow us to make some sort of liquid lock here. Let me actually move the ceiling upwards, and we're just gonna limit it with a bunch of tiles. If we place the door right here, we're limited to this area, 90 tiles plus 12. So I would have to take away 6 tiles to get to the 96. We'll also have a ladder to actually go down, and this is where I'm gonna have my grooming station. So you're gonna go right there. We don't actually need feeding stations for the Drekkos. We're gonna need farm plots. So instead of having these 6 tiles, we're just gonna have 6 tiles filled up with hydroponic farms. Last but not least, we definitely need a shearing station to shear those bastards. And also, just to show off, we're gonna build that out of obsidian. This is going to require a little bit of power. I have to see just how much and where we hook it up. With the addition of the metal refinery, we might actually be able to upgrade the one or other power transformer in this case. Once they have built the insulation around it, I also want to finish the liquid lock here. So let me just temporarily take this apart and we will be able to fill it. Actually, this is not even necessary. We can just put it right there. That's better. I'm not sure if I mentioned it yet, but the reason we want to have the liquid lock here is because we want specific gases. The flowers, balm lilies, are gonna require some chlorine in order to grow, but the Drekkos require hydrogen in order to grow their scales. This is also why you always find them in the biomes with chlorine and hydrogen. Now, in the beginning, we're not gonna deal with glossy Drekkos, we're gonna deal with just the normal ones. And in order to get glossy Drekkos, if my memory serves me right, is we need mealwood plants. I'm gonna set up about 3 plants that should be enough for the first conversion of the Drekko. I'm gonna go ahead and add a storage bin right here, just for completeness sake. Maybe we can store the plastic in there. And then we should check our room setup. It is now 96 tiles. Wonderful. Oh, actually, I have a better idea. We don't need this storage bin because there is something we are missing, and that is a critter drop-off point. We can now also start to fill up this liquid lock, enable auto bottle with a higher priority. Oh, actually, Devin is doing it instantly. Wonderful. I love my dupes. Aha! Well, you look at that. We have our first stone hatchling egg. This is all I wanted to see. I'm never gonna use the hatchlings for anything else, even if we use them to farm meat. I will always want the stone hatchlings. So I'm gonna put all my eggs into one basket, and that is gonna be this guy. On the other side, this Dracolet here, we want to wrangle up, and obviously we want to bring over here. So this needs to be built quickly. Alright, we want to set this up for Dracos and Dracolets. I think we might do us a favor replacing these hydroponic farms with just normal farm tiles for the mealwood phase. And then we switch it up to hydroponic once we start with the balm lilies. As a matter of fact, do they even need anything else? Doesn't say anything about liquids. We might actually get away just using chlorine and normal farm plots. So I guess the difficult part about this is to keep them above 35 degrees and in chlorine atmosphere, and it's not the irrigation that's nasty. In this case, we're gonna exchange all of these with normal farm plots. Also, I decided to just add another power transformer here. This is even easier than exchanging an entire system. Then all I can do is go down here, power up the Atmos suits, and we can continue down here, connect the shearing station. As a matter of fact, just to be practical, I'm gonna switch out the machinery. Grooming station and critter drop-off point are gonna go to the right side and the shearing station to the left side that requires the power. Power is in the center, so theoretically we can already build this safe. Come on. There we go. No. There we go. Looks like we have enough liquid in here. I'm just gonna disable this, get rid of the bottle emptier as well. Then, as mentioned, we want at least 3 mealwood plants for our first conversion. In these other farm plots, I'm already gonna set up the balm lilies, even though they are not gonna grow at first until we exchange the atmospheres. But back to our initial endeavor, we wanted to wrangle this guy up and bring him over to the new ranch. Finally, bird, that took you a while. No. That's sometimes a little bit annoying that they don't queue up the picking it up task right away. I mean, yeah, there we go. He wanted to do it, but the task only became available after completing the wrangling, and therefore they are not being efficient. Here we go. We have the Draco in place, and Bert might be grooming it soon. Actually, it's probably already happy and everything. Now we just need to wait for the first mealwood to grow. We also need to make sure we don't store the mealwood anywhere else, because, or the meal lies here. Otherwise, my duplicants are just gonna take it away from the Dracolet. I wonder something about meal lice. Could we just change the atmosphere here as well? No, they cannot do chlorine. Okay, so we have to at least wait somewhat. We can bring the pressure down to 150 grams already, so maybe we can at least do a little bit of the work pumping things out of here. And we're gonna do it as easy as it gets, just setting up the simplest of infrastructure for that. Getting the stone hatchling also means we don't need to save the sedimentary rock anymore. We want to release that, and instead we are going to introduce food for the stone hatchlings. It's not going to be sedimentary rock anymore, but it's going to be igneous rock. Because as mentioned, this is a renewable material from volcanoes. And there we go. We're already starting to pump things out. Maybe I want to automate this with a Atmos sensor, just to be sure I'm not messing this up. Let's place that here, connect it there. Actually, there's no sense in it. I did not realize that, holy cow, it's already at 300 grams. So we're not far off, actually. Oh, geez. This means we will not really take long to pump out this room, but we got everything prepared. I'm just gonna disconnect the gas pump. We need enough pressure for the mealwood. I wanted to go with great automation, but there you go. I guess at this point, however, we could go ahead, set up the Atmos suits. There's gonna be another station and just one dock, because we only really need our rancher to go in there as of this point. And I believe this would also require us to get another Atmos suit. We want to deliver that here. The rest is gonna be fairly easy because we already have the gas pipe here leading into the other Atmos suit stations, and we can just connect this. That was pretty much hassle-free, I would say. The thing about this process is it is going to take a while, so I'm guessing we're gonna come back to this, and as soon as we get the first glossy Draco egg, we will be able to switch the plants over and also exchange the atmosphere. However, one thing we can definitely do is already prepare it. We have all of this hydrogen and chlorine up here. We might not even have to do a lot of filtering if we think about the next steps. As a matter of fact, we could probably calculate just how much we need. All of this here until this point should be filled with hydrogen. Then just the bottom two tiles should be filled with chlorine. We have 26 tiles in this area minus the 6 farm tiles, meaning 20 tiles we want to fill up with chlorine at 2 kilograms per tile. That means somewhere we need to store 40 kilograms of chlorine, and that's gonna be the gas reservoir, I believe, at 5 kilograms per reservoir. So I'm gonna unlock that right away, and we will try to store as much chlorine as possible, or the exact amount, which is 40 kilograms. Now, usually I wouldn't really prepare this in advance. Just when I'm ready, I would go ahead and actually fill up the room with as much chlorine and hydrogen as I need. But since we have the spare time for it, let's be a little bit more precise. Holy cow, I was not sure what I was thinking. I had a brain fart there. It's not storing 5 kilograms, it's storing 150 kilograms. I knew there was a 5 in there. So now if we build this, hopefully we can also limit it exactly to the 40 kilograms we need. Also, you can see my Draco is now an adult and has been sheared for the first time. It is also groomed with a glossy Dracolet egg chance of 2% only at the moment. So this is gonna be somewhat of a long process. However, did we get the meal lice? Where did it go? I'm not sure. We'll have to see once the third one grows there. There it is. And we can limit it somewhat. Well, we can limit it with signals. But it's a percentage number. That kind of sucks. In this case, I want to make sure I do the input smart enough so that we can actually count the packets and then just stop it at the right moment. Just, I need 40 kilograms. Come on. We should be able to do this. Now we need to bring chlorine and hydrogen from all the way over here, down there. Sure enough, we can do that. This is only very temporary and I think we should be able to use the same pipe. Yeah, we don't need to build the pipe twice. So we are gonna do that. Then we head over here into this room and we can set up the two pumps as we please. Also, I'm gonna already build the second reservoir that is gonna be for the hydrogen. Let's see, if we already used up the 26 tiles, there should be 74 tiles left. However, we still have plus 4 tiles right here if we calculate everything. So 74 plus 4 would be 78 tiles that we have to fill with hydrogen. Just enough for the bomb lilies, but then everything else should be hydrogen so the scales can grow as quickly as possible. Whenever they spend time down here in the chlorine, then they will not be spending time in hydrogen. So technically, the narrower you can make your farm, the longer they will spend their time in hydrogen. But then you also have to think about the distance they have to walk in order to get to the grooming station that is gonna take a while. I mean, at the moment we don't have many critters, it doesn't really matter, but as soon as your rancher is really busy, you might want to avoid too long distances. Mealwood just grew, that means Devin is incoming and farming this plant. Then it should just lay down here, and this is when the Draco hopefully comes. New printables. No, 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 nothing exciting. Muckroot, are you serious? Anyways, I'm not sure if he's really hungry. Come on, eat it, eat it. But I guess my duplicates at least are not collecting it. That is good. Come on, eat it, you're right there. I guess they're not hungry. Otto, no! Okay, I knew there was something we forgot. We have to stop cooking the pickled meal. We don't want that anymore. Yeah, there we go. There is my meal license. Jeez. Okay, Otto just dropped it again. That is good. Should we bring the other back? I guess not. I mean, this guy doesn't seem too hungry yet. So I guess we can just let the other plants grow and we're gonna leave this here. Okay, I'm gonna do the first pump right here in the center of the chlorine. We're not gonna be pumping up any other gases. We can just make sure gases, yeah, it's all chlorine, except maybe a little bit of oxygen up there. But we can fix that by making a little opening. And then my second pump would go all the way up here to the highest point. So back to piping. This can then just go over here. And you can go over there. We want to do everything separately, of course, and kind of count the packages. Also, in terms of power, I think we can easily borrow some from here, just until we have pumped up enough gases. So just in case the Dracos actually want to eat from the plants, and something we should do anyways, is we don't want to auto-harvest here anymore. So if I can I disable that? Harvest, yeah, we don't want to do that here. Disable harvest. Okay, I'm always confused about that. Right there. Sorry, I changed this suddenly, so I'm acting like a noob. But I believe they might prefer the meal lice coming directly off the mealwood and the plants. Ah, we got our next grub egg. You're free to leave. Now, in situations like these, it's usually good to set up a signal switch for both of these guys. We're gonna do this simply, hook them up. And this way I will be able to control when these pumps are actually running. The switch by default we would like to set to off. Same thing here on the top. Maybe I'm gonna prioritize the switch. Well, I guess since I didn't hook up the pipes yet, it doesn't matter. Checking on my Draco at the moment, H7, reproduction 6%, and the chance of getting a glossy Dracolet egg went up by 1%. It is gonna be a slow process. So I will not be able to finish it in this episode, but I really hope I was able to help those who didn't understand how to build one of these, and then we just have to be a little bit patient to get the results. Come on. There is my switch. Thank you. We're gonna shut it off. Okay, we're ready to get this started. I'm gonna hook up the chlorine pipe first, and we're gonna start this. Switch to on. Now we can have 1 kilogram of chlorine per pipe, which means we want to count 40 pipes. What is 40? 40 is pretty long, approximately here. So we wanna get started by maybe cutting things away. And then up to this point, we should count exactly 40 pipes. Okay, I just have to remember this. Let me temporarily place something here. That's the end and, well, that's the beginning. Because unfortunately, if I cut things away, yeah, you can see it's not flowing right again. So we'll have to first connect it. Maybe one thing we can do to fix this is give them an output or an input here. If we just set up a bridge and then make sure it's not actually continuing from the bridge. Man, this is actually getting way too OCD. I could just, I know, fill up the tank. It doesn't really matter. But I'm kind of committed right now, so we want to make sure we fill up the pipe here, 40 pipes back, and that's the amount of chlorine we're gonna ship. And just when we filled up all of these, we are gonna disconnect this again. Things should be flowing back, and we have exactly 40 kilograms of chlorine in the joint. How wonderful. Let's finish this. It's gonna flow into the gas reservoir here. And oh my gosh, if that is not exactly 40 kilograms of chlorine, I'm gonna scream. It already went down. Let me see. Yes, we did it. Okay. And now what did I say? 78 of hydrogen. Actually, that's 70 here already. Plus the 4 right here. That's 74. Plus 6 tiles right here, which would be 80. So we need 160 kilograms of hydrogen. Are you serious? We can only store 150 here. So we're gonna need slightly more. That is quite unfortunate. Well, it doesn't matter. We're gonna disconnect this again. I'm gonna shut this off just to be sure. And then we're gonna connect the hydrogen pipe instead. You're gonna be switched on, and we wanna make sure, maybe here a little bit better, that we don't get any other gases. We wanna make sure this is all pure hydrogen. If we fill everything up to the point of this bridge, we should also be able to figure out just how much we have in there already. I'm not sure why I'm going through this in such detail, man. This is such an unimportant details to get the gases this correct. Oh well, who says A also needs to say B. Let's make sure we already fill these in. Ah, okay, like this it's actually not that bad. I'm glad I played around with this a little bit. Maybe we're gonna do more exact gases and liquids in the future. But yeah, let me just get this wrapped up. I wanna have 160 kilograms of hydrogen and then we're done with this part. Okay, we almost used up all of the hydrogen. You can now say we have quite a mixed pipe. So I wanted to show you another trick that I'm always using. Namely, we want to set up a gas pipe element sensor to detect the gases. And we want to set it up next to a gas vent that comes one pipe later in the line. We want to hook this up to some automation wire and then we need to detect the gases. However, I just noticed we have more than 2 gases in the joint, so we'll have to set this up differently. We'll have to cut this off and then hopefully I've already unlocked the NOT gate. We want to set this up here, connect the sensor to the NOT gate, input and the output to the vent. That means if we now detect hydrogen, we can send a green signal, which is going to be changed to a red signal, and therefore the vent is going to close, and hydrogen will be able to flow through, but everything else is going to be expelled. The Draco now already has a 9% glossy Dracolet egg chance. If we're lucky, we get it with the first egg. I highly doubt it, though. There is the sensor. We want to set this up right away, unbreathable, and it should be hydrogen. Now that everything is built, we can go ahead, reconnect the pipes, let the hydrogen flow through together with all of the gases we don't want. And if this functions properly, yes, hydrogen is gonna go through, but the oxygen and everything else is gonna be expelled. Absolutely fabulous. A good way to filter out gases and liquids if you don't mind spilling out the other stuff into the world. And you can really trust this filter. This is always gonna work and it's a power-free solution to filter out your things. But if you want to split things up into 2 pipes, then you're better off with the standard filter for 120 watts. There are also other methods using valves, but that is more advanced and I will show you that once we actually need such a thing. Oh yeah, I should also mention we were overpressured for a brief moment and that is when this contraption can fail. So if you want a fail-proof solution, then you need to make sure the environment also can take it. However, that is not the worst that could have happened. We can just make sure these guys are being expelled. That is good. I want to fill this up with hydrogen only. If we get all of these pipes full, we're gonna have exactly 10. This is great. I think we can do it. That wasn't quite as hassle-free as I would have liked it, but what you're gonna do, we're gonna disconnect this in case we need something in the future. But I wanna get rid of this entire pipe here, though it would be nice to expel the gases here at the bottom, so maybe we're gonna allow this to happen, and only after the fact we can take apart the pipes. Okay, now we basically just have to wait for the Draco to decide to lay a glossy Draco egg. Egg chance is already at 13% and it didn't even lay its first egg just yet. The process can easily take 80 or so cycles, so it's not worth just waiting for it. We should do other projects in the meantime and then get back to this. As soon as we get our first glossy egg, I'm gonna remove my mealwood. We're gonna pump out the room and then let those gases we calculated extremely accurately into the room. But until then, I would say we're gonna wrap it up for today. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Have a great time and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.